Hey guys, today is April 21st and we've finally returned to some spring-like temperatures. It's been pretty chilly the last few days. Rain and cold and maybe even some sleet mixed in. But in this video, we're going to take the Farmall H over to the house and get the new front wheels put on, hopefully. And I think that's probably going to, we'll probably check into this headlight here to see why it's not working. And that'll probably be it. At the end of the video, we'll reveal who won the contest. And I'll show you a couple of the items I'm going to be sending out to that winner. And thanks to everybody who participated. It was fun. Time was of the essence, obviously. So first come, first serve. Whoever had the correct answers, the first, the fastest. Well, they won. So let's go ahead and get this H fired up and go from there. We seem to have nothing here as far as seem to have nothing at the switch or something's going goofy here. What's going on? Everything's tight. Huh. Well, let's hand crank it, I guess. We'll have to figure that out too. Well, I'm not sure what happened there, but let's see if we've got some. Maybe the battery died or something. Well, we've got lights, so the lights work. Huh. Maybe the battery, died somewhere. I don't know why it would have done that, unless something is creating a draw on it in the electrical system. According to this, we are showing a draw. But I don't know how reliable this gauge is either. Okay, well, with it shut off, it's at zero. But I might as well disconnect the battery just to be safe, so that we're not drawing this thing down. I'm not sure where or why it would be drawing. So let me go ahead and disconnect the battery, and we'll go from there. All right, guys. So here's what we're looking at. Basically, what they did was they took this steel wheel, I believe it's a car wheel, obviously, because it had a V8 hubcap on it, and they bolted it to the cutoff steel front wheel for the H. But what we're going to do is take the cap off for the hub. Here we should have, but it doesn't look like we do. Essentially, it's a castle nut that has a bolt through it to clamp it into place, and there should be, I believe, a cotter pin that goes through the castle nut here, but I don't feel one, so there must not be one in there. So basically, we're going to loosen this nut and bolt, and then spin off the hub nut, and the whole assembly should come right off. So let me get a wrench here and a rag. Different size wrench. I'm not sure what's going on. There must be a draw on this battery or something. And I'm not an electrical guru, so not really looking forward to figuring that out. I'm gonna start with that headlight switch. Maybe that headlight switch is grounding out, because really that's about the only thing that I could draw. Other than the alternator, and I know that's wired right. So let me see here. I have to get a screwdriver to. And I'll probably reuse the bearings out of this. I'm going to check them here, but I don't anticipate them being bad at all. So nope, still plenty good. At least that one is. Actually missing a roller, so that one is quite loose. Thankfully I did get some extra bearings from Jim when I picked up the front wheels, so let's see, I've got an extra one here. Does need some cleaning. So let's see. Well, I'm gonna have to get a bucket here and some fuel and clean these bearings out. Looks like they need a little bit of cleaning, so let me do that real quick and I'll be right back with you. Alright guys, well, I cleaned up the races inside the wheels here. They look good, or at least inside this wheel, and there's no grooves or pitting, anything like that. Sorry, my new air compressor was running. I cleaned up the bearings. They move freely. They're a little loose, but that's okay. They'll work for now. But now I've got to repack these bearings. So in order to do that, I've got some extra heavy duty grease. And I'm basically just going to take a glob and put it in my hand. And I'm going to grab the bearing like this so that the back side is towards the end of my finger. And I'm just gonna keep going around until I see the grease coming out the front side of the bearing. And this is a messy process. See if I can turn the camera up a little bit here. It's quite a messy process. But it doesn't take long, especially if it's a smaller bearing. You can kind of see how it's coming through the front side of the bearing there. This one should be good to go. I'll put a liberal amount of grease all over it. And then I'll put a lot of grease on the bearing rings as well. Good to go and start on the next one. And actually, smaller bearings are kind of more of a pain in the neck because got some on my pants there. It's harder to hold it. That one. Make sure we grease everything up good. This is a messy, messy process, but if you want to maintain good bearings, you better take care of them. Because they're not going to grease themselves. Well, we put a bearing in first, huh? What did I do with it? Okay, I see one. Oh. It's right here. I put it in the wheel already. Side bearing. And then we've got to put on our nuts. want to snug it up just enough where you don't feel any resistance when it's turning. That's probably good right there. Put some gloves back on here before I get too greasy. Tighten it up and we should be good to go on this side. No noises. Let me move the camera here. Alright. Perfect. And just for good measure, put some grease on here. Just because. It never hurts. Put our cap back on. Now again, these are all used bearings. They're okay. They're not superb, but they're okay. They'll get us by for a while. But if I were going to do new bearings and new races, I would gunk in this hole here. If I were going to do new bearings and races, it's a broken bolt. Okay, well I guess we're only going to put two in for now. That'll have to be addressed at a later time. Anyways, if I was going to do new bearings and races, I would try to get as much out of these hubs as I could as far as the old grease and that goes. Alright. Well, for now, that'll have to be good. See if we can get this other side out. This wheel, I have to install this race, so that's why it was given to me. The other one didn't have the race in it. Getting a lot of grease on the floor here. Alright, let's go ahead and get this other wheel off and go from there. Alright guys, we got the other side all buttoned up. Everything's greased, and there is a cotter pin hole in the end of the axle shaft, or I should say spindle. So I did put a cotter pin on that side. I took this side back off and put a cotter pin in there. It runs horizontally, the cotter pin hole that's drilled through the shaft. Let's see. The bearing, the outer bearing on the other side literally fell apart in my hand. All the cage and bearings, rollers, came out right in my hand as soon as I took it off. Took it off the shaft, so not good, but I did thankfully have this extra bag of bearings, and I still have two leftover bearings here to use. They're not in the worst shape, but not in the best shape. So if I run into a pinch where I need a bearing, I've got a spare set for an H. So let's put this hubcap back on this side. And we can put this thing back on the ground. And I know what you guys are thinking, the setup I have for the jack is definitely not the safest, but you know, I don't have a bottle jack, and that's pretty much all I got to work with right now. So I just made sure that I did it the best way I could think of, and it worked. So we're back on the ground. And it looks like both tires are holding plenty of air. I filled them up to about 25 PSI or so. So let's get some of these tools cleaned up, get the jack put away, and then we'll start on figuring out what's going on with the battery draw. Well guys, I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but I suspect that it's the headlight switch, because on the back side where there's a resistor for the dimmer, this is the kind of shape it was in, and it was also touching the body of the light switch, which was essentially melted where it was touching. So my guess is that's what's causing the draw. I would assume that it's grounding out against the body of the light switch. So I'm probably looking at getting, if I can't get a new resistor, probably a new light switch itself. And then that's really got to be about it. So the charging system's working great. Seems to have it fully charged, but let's do a quick reveal as to who won the contest. Let me check out my phone here. I gotta look at the times of who won or who submitted what answers at what time here. The winner is Matthew Jarrett. So congratulations, Matt. You did well. You did well. To everybody else that submitted answers, thank you. I hope you had fun in trying to figure it all out. I tried to make it somewhat difficult for you guys, but Just a glimpse as to what you're going to be getting, Matthew. I've got a little care package for you. One thing is a gift card to Tractor Supply Company. I hope they have them in your area. If not, Well, I guess you can shop online. The second thing is I'm going to be sending out a license plate. So hopefully, I don't know if you guys are into that, but it'll give you something to hang on your wall. And the third thing is a souvenir from the Farmall M. This is one of the stuck pistons that came out of it. It's a 4-inch aluminum piston out of the Farmall M. And I know you guys spent a lot of time watching those videos, and I just thought I'd send this as a souvenir. You guys can hold something that actually came out of one of my tractors in your hand and put it on your shelf or throw it away. I don't care what you do with it, but I thought it might be kind of cool to send out to you guys. And I'm going to send one more piece of my profession to you. Do with it what you will, but I'm going to leave that one off of the video just because I like to keep my professional life separate from what I do in my personal life. So, congratulations. I hope you enjoy the little gifts I got for you, and stay tuned. Thanks for watching, guys. One last thing. I just checked my mail, and I got a package from Back Farms, and I believe this is probably a hat that they sent me, because I sent them a starter switch from my Farmall H that I had as a spare. There we go. Cool, man. I sure appreciate it, and I hope that switch works out for you. Let's see if it fits. It should. It's adjustable, so. Oop, a little too small. There we go. Everybody check out his channel. Michigan Farming, I believe it is. Thanks a lot, man. Talk to you later.